guys any help out there?
I'm just getting to.
Davey mentioned about it. I got you. Center?
Hello. How's it going?
Remember, you missed out. You guys are gonna need it.
I know, I had to prepare for this.
You guys have two request section.
Okay.
One from Kama and
your page. You can go for the meeting if for the service events. Request me for the service, right?
Sorry.
Are you requesting me for the service event?
Yes. For what our service event that we pitched to you guys?
Based on the request, I have do you have a service event coming up?
Yeah, we have a few.
Yeah, so
are you from Gamified Health?
Yes, I am. Good afternoon, you guys.
Hello.
Hey.
So, great. This time, basically, this will be doing. If you guys have any questions based on your request, you can ask them, then I can present to you, like how we used to do.
Yeah,
I can. So, you can look at the request and if any questions you have, you can ask them.
Are you recording this?
Yes, this is.
Oh my goodness.
Come on, in case we have.
Okay, so you are making two requests. One for the Hope for Haiti?
Yes.
And one for Shoes for Scholarship?
Yes.
Okay. Could you just explain a little bit?
The Hope for Haiti, we are just donating clothes and non-perishable items, and the money is just requested for just the shipping.
Okay.
And what other one? What other one?
The Shoes for Scholarship.
Shoes for Scholarships. Over the summer, we went to St. Aloysius, I believe, with a few other organizations, and afterwards, a few of the girls walked up to us and wanted us to be their mentors. So we have like six girls over the summer. We, you know, kind of got to know them a little bit. And the Catholic school that they go to, four of the girls work off their tuition. And it's in an urban neighborhood. And we figured we can kind of pick one or two from them and get them something for Christmas. Which is for, it's J for A, so we would be talking to their principal and finding out whoever has the best report card. So we have some shoes.
So from Mass G, you guys requesting $500 for room rent?
Yes. Which month is that for? What's the event called?
What is the last one?
Yes, that is our probate show. And I requested the auditorium, and I checked the space before I did. And it was okay. I got a submission that said it was okay, and then I got one that said the room is not available. So I do have to go check on that room. But that's for promotional items. For jackets for the girls.
And next, you are requesting food tasting $40?
Yes, we are going to do like a women's fringeum here,
mm-hmm.
where we just talk to all the women here and just talk about different issues that as women that we come across. And that's just for snacks.
And the conference and then the founder days?
Say that again, I'm sorry.
The founder days to $80?
Oh yeah, that's our conference in I believe it's Springfield, Michigan.
That's off campus, right?
It's off campus, yes.
And
is that $80? I think that's just for the registration.
Yeah. Can you tell me where the main courses is that?
Oh, Oh, I am unique event. Yeah, we had that last February where we honor our founders, and it's just a business panel. And we just give tribute to beautiful women. So.
All the events are open to the public, right? Have you seen issues with that?
The...
All the events you have holding money for request from SGA.
Well, the probate will, the I Am Unique event, yes. The Women's Pendulum is just for CSU students.
No, I'm saying all, this is just for CSU students, right? It's open for every CSU student.
Yes, absolutely.
The regional conference, where's that at?
That one is, I believe, in Michigan.
Detroit, Michigan.
Yes.
What's the last thing, the membership you wrote?
The
membership?
Membership. I can't read what that is, I'm sorry. You said membership what?
Yeah.
That is the probate.
Can you tell me something about that?
Well, it's people on campus, women that's prospective members that join our organization, and we do the revealing, and usually they get jackets and other paraphernalia.
Based on your request, everything's looked reasonable. So, finance committee has to look over all the requests and the business number. Do you have any questions?
Yeah, just one thing. What do you know the dates for either of these two things, for the Haiti or the shoes?
The Haiti one, we're still gathering clothes and non-perishable items. We're working with our grad chapter with that. So, and we just kind of gave about a round of, you know, we estimated it to be for shipping. But we had another person that we're going to talk to see exactly the amount, because we just need that for just shipping.
And then for the shoes for scholarship, was this money specifically for buying shoes to give to them?
Yeah, it's kind of J's for A's. Yeah.
J's for A's.
Yeah. It's just for the girls that we did the mentor program to, and it's just for them.
For that one, we probably won't be able to fund it for the shoes because it's not a service event, it's just buying the shoes for the girls, but they need to know that it will probably do that.
Okay.
But yeah, we also have to look over everything and go through streamline, and we'll let you know as well. Thank you.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Take care.
We'll email you like information and let you know.
Okay. Thank you.
Speaking with Rob Stegman, speaking with Ron, who's the new director of student involvement, about how important it is for MPAC to be prolific on campus. Like, just since standing here is a long time coming. MPAC Week, for us, it's just a way to add to the goals of the university as engaged CSU diversity and inclusion. Bernard Williams, who's president of MPAC, will elaborate more on what MPAC Week is and why it's so important.
MPAC Week is basically a week for MPAC to interact with the students, get involved on campus and in different programs, helping with fun activities, community involvement, stuff like that, doing some service at the end of the week. We did one last year, but we had to fund it ourselves, and it wasn't as big as it should have been, and it was so short notice, and we weren't helped too much with our staff. I guess Jill and Rodolfo were new, and it just didn't go as planned, but we've been sitting down with Ron a lot, planning events, trying to get some sponsors and everything involved. So, and then involve other Greek orgs that's not in the PhD just to help. We talked to some of the teachers about doing some events. We talked to a few orgs, and we're still trying to get more orgs. And it's kind of like a spinoff of Greek Week, which we're planning to. So with that, you know, we just want to get involved and engage in the diverse community and also everybody, so.
Yes, ma'am.
What is the date for this event?
We want to do it, if not in Black History Month, because we're trying to do something throughout the whole Black History Month, which we have requested funding for,
uh-huh.
Probably like the next month, like March is.
March.
So it could be, we want it to be more outside events, not just, so not too cold, but maybe have like a picnic, a block party to cap it all off.
Okay. I serve as the SGA advisor, but I also work with major campus events, and you said that last year you didn't really have a lot of staff help, except the Jill and Rodolfo thing. So mm-hmm. I just want to offer you any assistance that you might need with your event. Jamie Johnston, and I unfortunately don't have business cards to give you, but my name is kind of easy to remember. If you give me your email address, I can send an email too, so that way I can help you kind of coordinate your event.
Thank you.
Sure.
It sounds like a really great week. For your line items here, it looks like it's mainly, you know, printing, room rental, promotion, food. So I think it sounds awesome. I really want it to happen, but I think I need a little bit more specific on like the service aspect of it, because what we need to fund is like specifically service events.
Last year we did our Make a Difference Day, so we all rallied up and we went to paint. The Masonic Theater. It was the Masonic Theater. We painted the wheelchair dance. So that was some of the service we did last year, and we did another service throughout the week. We had a penny war throughout the orgs, and then we donated it to you guys. Mariah has the logistics, but she graduated. But it was your like service cause of the month, I want to say. I can't remember what the cause was right now. But we did a penny war for that. And Mariah dealt with all that.
What we're gonna go back to was last spring, SGA and Arch and Alpha Phi Alpha, we partnered on the Fresh Mark Flint campaign. And we also partnered with Sig Epps from John Craig University. And we're gonna do a follow-up campaign so that a lot of people, they don't want to reapproach that thing, but it's still a problem. So between the Fresh Market campaign, redoing the service events we did, like painting more infrastructure in Cleveland, beautifying, like it's still on the table because we've just started to begin meeting with Ron about the service events. So we haven't put them on stone, but that's what we're going. But those are where we want to take it as far as piggyback on what we did last semester. And also piggybacking on that Fresh Walker Flint campaign and not leaving that community to the wayside.
Right. Okay. Yeah, I think just for us being able to differentiate that, like you said, at the end of the week of the picnic, like we wouldn't fund a picnic, but we would fund the service.
So
understood. Being able to know that.
100%.
Thank you.
For the SGA, just the Black History Month, the question about the remarketing of t-shirts.
Yeah. So what normally goes on is that when Black History Month occurs, there's outside entities doing it for us, when that's something that's college students, especially as Divine Our organizations, when a lot of prolific Black leaders come from our organizations and have been involved in the maturation of our culture. We sitting down with Ron, he said that that's something we have to uphold and do, and uphold into ourselves as a Divine Nine Council. Like a lot of the things is just basically like marketing, because rooms, we can book rooms here. We look to host it on the Cleveland State campus. So having the correct marketing resources to spread the word and to even continue to add to the ecosystem of Cleveland State, because Cleveland State is the center of downtown Cleveland. A lot of companies come in and out here and use Cleveland State as a segue to further boost their brand. So we're not going to limit it just to MPAC. It'll be MPAC collaborating with other organizations like the Black Student Union and even Black Studies as a whole. Because normally they usually do it by themselves. And for a long time, MPAC hasn't stepped forward and really acted the way we're supposed to act on campus. So this is just our way of coming to the forefront and saying, well, we're here now, and this is what we're supposed to do. And we should be the body that's held accountable for a good percentage of the diversity and inclusion efforts on the campus.
Can you tell me how much it per shirt costs?
Per shirt cost, the screen, we're gonna use screen print. So per shirt, $10. Yeah, $10 to $20 was the quote we had. No.
It's all that number of extra.
No, not 15.
$1,500
for the
question.
Yeah.
$1,000 for 100 shirt.
No, so the 1500 is for more than t-shirt, just for marketing material. So whether it's t-shirts, banners, creative grassroots marketing, to whether we decide that we want to do, we use something called additive manufacturing, which is 3D printing. So we will give people things that keep them themselves. We're trying to diverge away from flyers. You give people flyers and leave them all around campus. If you give themselves lifelike that they can take home with them.
For the next, you guys are requesting $2,000 for the
and that's another thing Brian talked to us about. So he's basically discussing the retention and Greek life. Cleveland State doesn't even, out of all the students here, we have over 20,000, not even 5% are Greek. And we're losing a lot of students because of things that may go on behind closed doors between all the organizations, and especially for Divine Nine. Divine Nine Greeks are always in the news for that. So that's another thing that MPAC hasn't been happy about. And we know that when people join Greek organizations, they graduate, they get back to their communities, and they create a pipeline. But we can't have a pipeline if we aren't approaching the problem. It's like people know it happens, but we don't even talk about it. But it's important to talk about it, because you lose a lot of good people who can be stakeholders and add to the brand of Cleveland State University. So that's what that means.
You guys are requesting $1,000 for the promotional item t-shirt, $250 for the food, and $750 for the social event. Can you detail on the social event?
So,
Different stuff. So we had an idea, it's a movie called Haze. The quote on that was like $500. So we would feed people, and then we would watch the movie and direct out for an extra like $500. You could get the director to come and explain the movie. We kind of had a similar event last year during Greek Week, where we played an episode of a TV show, and they were like being hazed, and we like had a question and answer with all the Greek orgs, so like IFC and NPC. And they just like talk, and we just talk to people or their concerns on why they didn't want to join some orgs versus others, how to get into the orgs, people like stereotypes, stuff like that. So that's just like a couple of events. I mean, like watching the Haiti movie, getting people aware of what was going on, why, like it used to happen back in the day, and now it's illegal now, and just keeping people up to date.
Is your events open to every station?
Yeah.
Bernard.
That's me.
I just sent you an email, so you have some
time. You said Jamie Johnson.
Yep.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
Yeah, appreciate it.
Now we're
going to talk about
this.
Thank you. Have a great day. Right. Thank you. We can talk about your event.
the.
Okay.
Thank you.
No, I got it. Yeah, I'm flipping. So we're gonna go back the same way. So is this mine?
Hello.
What? You're on the other side of the table?
Yeah, I know. I'm so used to being a spectator over there.
We're gonna ask so many questions.
So
it's alright. I'm willing to answer everything.
They actually had a request from VE for they're not doing anymore, so they only have a request for VE.
I had a request for VE place, and I talked with the board, and I thought that we should better push it back to the next hearing.
Okay.
I'd rather we come with something much more prepared and concrete than something that we kind of just came up with.
I like the way you think.
So I'd rather save you guys know what is this kid doing, rather than coming with something good, so.
So the first, you guys are requesting $500 for the Air Girls Night Out?
Yes.
Okay.
So the Air Girls Night Out is a way for the Air Student Union to unite the multiple Air groups that are on campus. And the way we want to do that first is we want to have this kind of Ivy Girls Night Out, in which a lot of the Arabs on campus specifically are both a part of the Muslim Student Association and the Saudi Student Association. And a lot of these girls, they wear the headscarves. And there's a cultural tradition that they have these small women parties in which they're women only, and they have music and dancing in which the women are able to take off their headscarves. If they wear the niqab, take off the niqab, and wear these very elegant dresses, and look beautiful for themselves, and a way for the women to interact. We have our hafnas here on campus, but they are mixed, so I feel that kind of element for the Arab girls to really come together and have that religious cultural barrier be broken down. So that's kind of an event that I would like to have sort of place that set.
So it's open to every
it's open to every CSU student, but we ask that girls only come just to respect the cultural and religious barrier.
So non-Muslim girls?
Non-Muslim girls are actually encouraged to come. We want you to come. We want you to come, and we want you to see what we do and how it is.
So the rental for Arabic food, is it group?
Yes, so that invoice that we have is, it's from the same Ken Zaman restaurant that we're using for our hafla. That's actually tomorrow, so thank you guys are free. We're having our fall hafta tomorrow.
For the 150 for the coffee.
Did you get a waiver?
Yes.
Perfect.
Yes. Everything is in. Kevin is.
Yeah, actually helped.
He helped me out with that. Kevin.
Nice job, brother.
And I heard there was like something with the student organization. There was something going. I went to go talk to Dan. And he was like, "We gotta talk about this later." But Harinder helped me out.
Perfect.
He's one of the best treasures.
Good.
Coffee talks are just listening.
Yes, so the coffee talks, I originally put on that there was only one coffee talk. We changed it and we'd rather do it to two, which would be one in February and one in early March. That's just gonna cover the supplies for the coffee talks and any other extra decorations that we're gonna do. Those coffee talks are more cultural discussions. We're gonna kind of, it's a cultural practice to have a lot of people come together, sit on the ground and drink some coffee and tea and just have open discussions. No judgment, no barriers, and really get people involved and engaged. So we want people to come and learn. We want people to learn about other cultural traditions.
Will those be open and advertised?
Those are open and advertised for everyone, yes. All of these events that I've placed are open for everyone at CSU, except the Ivy Girls Night Out. We want girls to learn.
Right. Is that open to, do you guys have it in a previous event?
Yes, so the coffee talk is actually where we've requested funding for the coffee talk for this semester at the last hearing, and we're gonna have our first coffee talk in November. So, so far we've started planning and people are excited about it.
So you're investing with this for the next?
This is for next semesters, yes.
And for the next, you're investing for a spring half?
Yes, so the spring half of it is going to be just the spring version of what tomorrow's event is gonna be. We do it every semester. All of the prices and invoices for the food is going to be the same, except next year, usually since the springtime, we expect more people. We would like to bring a performer, so a deaf kid performance, or a singer. I believe on there I put henna, but I think we decided to X out from henna. We don't want to do henna anymore. We'd prefer just to bring in a singer and the deaf kid, which is the kind of traditional cultural dance.
We're removing henna, cut down the money from singer.
No, the henna was just kind of like, maybe we'll do a performance or henna. It was kind of to give you guys options.
And next you have a white helmet screening?
Yes. So the white helmet screening is, there's a documentary on called The White Helmets, and it talks about the volunteers in Syria that go in and they save people from the rubble. It's more of a, in the war that's going on in Syria, this is more kind of a educational video that we want people to come in and learn about the conflicts that are going on and how people are willing to go and resolve the conflict. So it's going to be kind of half educational, half for people to come together and learn. We would like to do it in the Fenn Tower movie theater. Have some popcorn, have some food for people to come. And hopefully it'll be nice. All of you guys are welcome to come.
Any questions?
Well, it's a Senate initiative this year to attend all the events that we fund. So
oh, yeah. Please come tomorrow. Tomorrow, we're so excited. Food's going to be great. I know that the World Series is going on, so we're trying to have like a stream going on. So like people can go watch it during, like, and then like in between the innings, go dance.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thanks.
Have a good day, everyone.
Take care. Okay.
I've got to run, but I just want to thank you. I think you're doing a tremendous job.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Take care.
See you, Jamie.
Bye. Nice work. Absolutely. Hey, how
are you?
Hello again.
Hi.
I'm Allison Catanzaro from the Student Nurses Association. So I wasn't sure what the protocol was about making a couple shifts, so I wanted to just make sure that that was okay. And then we were going to request a little bit more funds. So one of our shifts was, was, I guess, actually for the VE people. Are you still here?
You had a request for VE?
Yeah. What we did was they granted us $1,500 for airfare, and we were they granted us $1,200 for airfare and $300 for making blankets. Mm-hmm. We actually got funding for the supplies for the blankets, so we were wondering if we could apply that $300 towards the airfare to Dominican Republic.
That would have to be a separate request, because how we're doing it this year is, if unfortunately they're gone, but you'd have to request it from them. How we're doing it this year is, just because you get $1,500 doesn't mean you get $1,500. It's just
right.
Specific for whatever items that you did request.
Right.
So at this point in time, we couldn't say yes, you can spend the additional money that they gave you on the blankets on the flight, but you could contact the each treasurer and say that you want to come and talk to the board.
Okay, so that was what I was hoping to do today. That's what I put in our
They were here for the first part, and because they didn't have any more requests, they ended up for the day.
Okay.
So for the SG, you're requesting $1,000 for the research day?
Yes, so you graciously granted us $500, so we were going to request $500 more for speaker honorarium, so we could have a speaker come for that.
So you just requesting five, we already gave you 500, right?
Yes.
So we allocated you 3,500 in the first year, right?
Right.
The max you can get from us is 1,500 more.
For the whole year?
For the whole year. So 5,000 is the max for the academic year.
Right.
Spring.
So we were asking for 500 more for interdisciplinary research day, so we could have a speaker honorarium, and then $1,000 for a celebration in the spring. Hopefully.
You have your, so $500 for the speaker and $1,000 for what?
The School of Nursing Community Celebration, which we'll be having in the spring.
That's the last page. So you need a promotional item for that? $1,000 for the t-shirts and print from here?
So the t-shirts we were thrilled with, so we're going to keep that. So So the only additional would be for the honorarium and for the school of nursing celebration.
$1,500 requested from.
Yes.
Any question about the donation? No, it's true.
It's $200.
No, she already requested that last year, but she's for it.
Oh.
You should be good, and we'll let you know in a week that you have any decision on that.
Okay, that's great. And so I should just then contact VE?
Yeah, VE, but VE.
Okay.
Or Jamie might help you with that, or they'll contact VE for it.
Yeah, if you just contact Dan Jacob Bison, who's their treasurer.
Treasurer.
Uh-huh.
I can send you email if you want.
Okay, that's great. Okay, thank you very much.
No problem.
Yes, I already figured out.
Yes, we were at that.
Yeah.
Brittany, I sold your, or Emily, I sold your folder.
Oh, it's fine.
Okay, all right.
We have a lot of,
This is a short.
We just finished the fourth one.
Wait, this is.
At 3:30.
These are fall for today?
Yeah. Pretty much having a sleepover this year.
Last time we sat here.
The globe is not here, so you can skip the next one. What's the next one, the globe?
Next one is American Institute of Graduate.
Christian Fellowship?
You missed one, is it?
I kind of.
So the globe is not here?
Not here.
Okay. So they're done?
No show.
Institute of Graduate.
Yeah. Institutions. So you guys are requesting $2,500 for the field trip?
I think the total out of the thing, $3,300.
Yeah, well, this is being individual.
Oh, okay, great.
For the trip, $1,250.
Thank you.
Or $2,500 for the trip.
$25. The max we can fund to off campus is $2,000.
Okay.
Okay.
But can you tell me a little bit about the trip?
Sure. Last year we went to Columbus. We got to visit two design firms, one that specialized in branding for colleges across the country, and one was involving animation that's also involved with branding across a lot of clients across the country. So it's really good to get our feet into that field of the career that we're looking into and develop relationships outside of Ohio, at least, too.
How many people are going?
Last year we had 10, so probably the same amount this year, 8 to 10.
And the next, you guys are requesting $450 for the
Archer.
Yeah.
So this year we're doing a first ever design specific show through our program.
So is the food from CHU Caterers?
I believe so.
Yes.
Yes.
Just asking $100 for supplies too.
Sure, to hang work mounted across the campus.
And the last thing that I'm requesting, $350 for the sweatshirts?
Sure. Last year we did t-shirts where we marketed and printed ourselves. So we're asking for that as well.
Yeah, last year we did a little bit backwards. We had people like order them and then we went out and bought them, but they said this year that we shouldn't do that. We need to order the t-shirts first.
Do you have a quotation for the t-shirts?
I'm sorry?
Do you have a quotation, a cost cut down for
them? Let's see, it only costs about $10 to make.
So
we
mentioned
$30.
Any else?
Any questions? We will email you in 2 weeks and let you know.
Okay, all right, thank you very much.
Thank you.
They should be. Are you handing out the follow-up to the vendor? Is he handing out the follow-up paper?
Sorry?
The follow-up paper that we did last time?
I think he'll be emailing everybody after the meeting.
Okay.
He said. Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, no.
Because last time we gave everybody, and again, they emailed us for the follow-up sheet.
Okay.
Okay, that makes sense, thanks, everybody.
Oh, yeah, bye, guys, good job.
Bye.
Isn't any student organization coming?
Then I have.
Bye.
Bye. The ISO is not here, so we can skip them.
Oh, wow. American Planning Association?
I'm our treasurer, Jim Anderson.
I'm you.
Hi, good to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
So, first you're requesting 20 feet showing for the national conference?
Yes.
In New York?
Yes.
Can you tell us a little?
And then, primary factor, you know, the bed is that it's in the spring. I'm not sure if that was explicit in the description.
Yes, May 6th, July 9th.
Yeah, yeah. So the American Planning Association, our national level, has a conference every year. Last year was in Phoenix, we had eight-party membership, and then two post-grads. And so we go on forum, hosting sessions dealing with everything from economic development, environmental justice, social justice, unemployment, land use, infrastructure, specifically utilities, and then those forums for the primary session. The primary extent of the initial sessions are all free, and then there are post-conference sessions that do come at an expense. For the most part, I think there's only two or three members that participated in the sessions that came at a cost. So that isn't factored in to our cost there. We leave that up to our members, as if it increases the funding for all of us if we don't factor that in to our cost. What the primary funding is for is the room and board, our transit costs, and then the registration fee.
How many members in this year?
We're expecting 10, because it's a lot closer. Last year was in Phoenix, and we had 8. So,
okay. So the room rental is $1,520?
Yeah, all those numbers were based on the 8 members last year, and then I had 2.
So the max you can fund you is $2,000 off campus?
Okay.
And you requested 320, so can you make up the rest?
Yeah. I figured might as well get the full equated cost, and then we'll be able to figure out the rest.
And the second request you have is $300 for the Browns watch party?
Yeah.
So, food, how much have you from Cajun here?
So, I did have a question regarding that. With the, is off-campus catering, our host location is B2B, is that supplemented by campus catering, or is that an exempt expenditure?
You have to have a food vendor waiver from catering services to get it off campus catering.
Okay, so that food cost would be, say again?
Do you have a waiver signed?
No. I was told by those Yolanda that based on that we weren't bringing it on campus, we didn't need that waiver.
Where is the event taking place?
Porter Severe on Euclid, across the street.
Uh-huh.
Across the street.
So you're
off campus.
So what kind of food will you have there? Food?
We're doing burgers. The venue is, let's say, 699 burgers and then 67 wings, with the cost of admission, which is a wristband,
okay.
And that's our primary.
No alcohol will be involved with that.
There is a wristband for 21 and over. But that expenditure is not at all factored in.
Just as long as no alcohol expenditure is factored in, because no student funds can go for the purchase or for the discount of any alcohol beverages.
Correct.
Okay, so thank you so much for your time. We'll let you know in 2 weeks what we have to do.
And then there was a third background there.
What was that?
It was the bi-weekly meetings.
I only had 2 on those
things. You only have 2. One's the ground for the party and the other one the conference.
What was the third one you can tell us?
We have bi-weekly meetings that we host a guest speaker dealing with, you know, if you will, it's a short session and localized session of the national conference. So we dealt with economic development and
how much you request?
Education development. It was 200 for food expenses.
So it's 200.
One hundred fifty.
And I covered that.
That's what it was.
That's why I didn't print it out.
I gotcha. All right. Awesome. Thank you.
Thanks, sir.
Have a good day.
And you said in 2 weeks.
In 2 weeks.
Back.
Yes.
Awesome.
I mean, the 200 comes under 250, right? That's why I didn't
know. Yeah. Just gotta make sure that when we do our deliberation that we make that group know that they cannot use any of that money towards any alcohol or towards that discount of alcohol.
Who's gonna supervise that this money is going for alcohol or not? That is the only issue because it's not on campus.
They will have to provide an itemized list of what was paid for.
At CSU, our program views school psychologists as agents of change in children's lives, focusing on children's behaviors and functioning with families, school, and communities. So our third year student internships would be honored if they could attend our National School Psychologist Conference in San Antonio, Texas. And so to do so, we are requesting for financial assistance for help because this trip can be pretty costly. And NASP is a great way to show it has excellence in learning, experience with countless presentations on topics such as school safety, our grade retention, ADHD, racial and ethnic divides in education, and it will also provide a great foundation for us as far as networking opportunities and to share our research, which was accepted to conference this year, so we really wanna show what we've been working on so hard. So our cohort would be also able to advance their education in leadership and effective practices to improve student learning, behavior, and mental health. So additionally, these funds will help our cohort pay for airfare, hotel accommodations, convention registrations, gas activities, and any other professional development opportunities. So we really appreciate it.
So your question is $3,600, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know that max we can fund is $2,000.
Correct. We just wanted to list everything that was on there because we weren't sure what money would allocate for what, so we just wanted to give you the whole itinerary as far as what.
Do you have the rest of the money in your account already?
We do not.
So how do you get
how do you plan to spend the extra money out of $1,600?
Yeah, so we're gonna
get the $1,600.
The students would have to pay for it.
So
the three that are going. Money.
We have to discuss that as a group, so
yes.
We'll let you know if you can.
Okay,
thanks.
Wonderful.
Nice.
Thank you.
So max off campus is 2,000,
and there's a few.
That's the maximum on campus.
2,000.
Okay.
So
really?
It takes 5 years to join. It's not over $5.
$5.
I got help that one. How are the new guys doing? New guys and girls?
Wonderful.
Good?
I'm asking
questions. Are there any questions you have, like the whole process? Is there anything you're not understanding?
It looks fine, though. Which one?
I think it's a good look.
Okay.
How did these all, how did these answer?
They're nice, and what's the response?
How much? I understand.
That's pretty different.
You know, not doing the same thing.
I want to be great.
I know, I like that.
Chief, that got heated. A little bit.
Students.
Like, cool, but Ruth came in requesting, this is not, that we're running for travel, and.
Oh, I see you.
I wish Dr. Moore was.
Testing $7,000 for a before year.
Because that's what we have requested.
Yeah, we can check our.
And that was.
I've been asking well, I guess.
Okay, since I have prepared some of the slides.
Like, you have a slide to show?
Yeah, you don't actually have it here today.
The conversation.
So we already are back to $5,000.
Yeah.
I feel like this part two days are to be.
In the last few years, like, so just an active screening that I have, like.
Oh, yeah.
So it takes every effort to actually see students.
Off campus.
And then $5,000.
No, no.
The total is $5,000.
Total is $5,000.
Other students, I haven't heard that one yet.
That's where the.
Student Social Society, and that's a group that takes.
So this is just required regardless.
This would be.
Possible.
But otherwise, I don't.
I mean.
You still.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. At five.
Exactly.
No.
That's why I did it. Okay. So hello, everyone. I'm Saman. I'm the treasurer of the Student Agrarian Region of Cleveland State University. Before starting, I would like to thank all of you and the SGA committee who helped us to make our last event possible. We are thinking to repeat our last event. I just briefly present our motivation. Our motivation for Notice 2017 is as follows. You know, as you may know, in past years, the number of Iranian students at CSU has increased. So we are thinking to gather Iranian students and celebrate Nowruz. And Nowruz is the main significant event in Persian culture, in our culture. So that's why we like to host that cultural celebration. And also, this event provides an opportunity for other CSU students and faculties to join us and become familiar with Iranian culture. And it is good to know that Nowruz is also known and appreciated in other countries like Afghanistan, Tajikistan, Pakistan. And those students from those countries can also join us to celebrate Nowruz. And there are some photos for our event, our last event, Nowruz 2016. It was open to all CSU students. We have many CSU students and also faculties. You know, as you can see, there are some photos during our event. In the photo in the right, you can see my supervisor from Electrical Engineering Department and his wife. And also there are some more photos during our event. And also, we were really successful to greatly represent CSU, and we had great feedback from our guests, especially our non-CSU guests. And also, there are some CSU students who are playing music for us using Iranian traditional instrument. And we are thinking to have Nowruz event this year with your help. And that's it.
So you're requesting the total cost is $7,000, right?
Yes.
The next weekend allocated $5,000.
Yeah.
You can't do it. Why is the food so expensive? $4,200?
Yeah, because it is actually I think it is $7 per person, and it depends on our budget. And also it is like a special Iranian food that we do in our New Year night. And there are the
kinds of play. I think if we want to do that in other restaurants, it will be the same. Since it's full of meat, things like that, and they're expensive.
Where is the food coming from?
It is coming from Chicago.
Oh.
There's a local restaurant that could do this?
Actually, there is not an Iranian restaurant in Cleveland, and this one is the nearest and cheapest restaurant around Cleveland. And they have catering, that's why we order food from Chicago.
Are they going to deliver the food? They drive?
Yeah, they drive.
I remember we funded this event last year to get them $5,000.
Can I ask a question? I remember that you charged $10 for non-CSU students. Was there any revenue that you generated from that?
What?
There was. You were charging last year $10 for non-CSU students.
Okay.
Did you generate any revenue from that? Did you bring in any money?
Any what? I can't remember something.
Last year you guys charged $10.
Yeah, I know.
Did you guys collect any money in your account?
No, actually, since for last year our expenses was about 8,000, and then we calculated that $10 in a way just to compensate the prices over 5,000, so we don't make any money, and that $10 is just for, like here we, our expenses is about 7,000, and it may be more than that, but we will set the price for non-CSU guests to compensate for all our expenses.
$10 to cover the expenses.
Yes.
Over $5,000.
Yeah, the difference.
Any questions? I will email you in 2 weeks and let you know what.
Good.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. We need an Iranian restaurant in Cleveland. What is
the
problem?
It's an opportunity right there.
I know. All
they
might
do that after our graduation.
All of my Iranian guys, they were upset that they didn't have a restaurant here.
Yes, exactly.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you.
My name is Gabrielle Stahl, and I'm a fourth year health science major here at Cleveland State. I'm also the secretary in a vital subject for CRIM.
I'm Jemeni
Ukola.
I'm a sophomore here at CSU, health sciences pre-OT major, and I've been involved with CRIM for a year and a half now, and also a vital
subject. Okay, so about the spring conference. Spring break is an incredible time for CRIM. During spring break, CRIM offers many tricks for students who would like to go outside of their comfort zone, engage with people in various places around the United States and other countries. This year, CRIM wants to embark on a journey to Panama City Beach to engage with students and other members of the surrounding community down there. Last year, I was able to join CRIM on their trip to Chicago as part of the Urban Immersion Studies. On this trip, I got to talk to people about their beliefs and teach them a little bit about what I believe as a Christian and as a member of CRIM. Coming back home was one of the hardest things I've ever had to do from that trip. I was so excited to come back home though because I had learned so much over that week in Chicago. Most importantly, I learned how to engage with people who were different from me in a loving, respectful manner. Because of this trip, I had not only gained knowledge about bringing people closer to God as is part of the mission of our organization, but I had also gained knowledge about being a people person and understanding the intricacies of other people's lives who are have cultures and ethnicities different than mine. I believe that what I learned on this trip has undoubtedly and will continue to aid me as a student at Cleveland State. CSU prides itself on how it engages its students, whether it be in the classroom, around the community, or around the globe. The kind of engagement CSU speaks of in its university pride is especially important because of the level of diversity here in the state. Spring Break in Panama City would not only help the purpose of our organization, but it would also help us as students of the university as culturally diverse as Cleveland State, so that we can learn to engage with others of various ages, cultures, and ethnicities. To conclude, for mine, I would just like to say thank you for your time. And personally, I would like to thank you for your funding last year, which helped me go on the trip. If not for your gracious gift, I would not have been able to go on this trip that has honestly changed my life. So I would like to sincerely thank you.
How many people are going to this?
How many people? Since it's so far away, we don't have an exact number yet. We can only ask people if they're interested. And we have, at Cleveland State, about 30 or 40 students in crew. From that number, I would say at least 10 would be interested in going. And
how many last year?
How many last year? Four. Four. Four, not including our crew
staff.
And the cost of this trip for spring break is, sorry.
What is crew staff?
Crew staff, they're not part of the student population here. They're just, like crew is a nationally, or worldwide actually, organization, but it focuses on college students a lot of times, so they're just working with us here.
So they're not students?
No, they're not students.
Did our expenses last year cover the staff at all?
No, it did not.
Okay.
Nope. And for this year, Panama City Beach is $350 for each student. That does not include traveling and food and all that. It's strictly for the living at, in the hotel or wherever we're living this year.
So there's two conferences, one in spring, one in winter, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And I could talk about the winter conference. The winter conference for crew is called NBCC. So students from all around the Great Lakes region all come to Indianapolis for a week about to like all come together to grow spiritually, mentally, as well as emotionally together by listening to speakers who come and tell us about their stories and experiences and hardships they've overcome in the past and ways we can learn from their experiences. Last year, I went to NBCC, my first year, and it taught me like how to view things differently and like have a new, fresh perspective and a positive outlook.
It's the same people who go to the winter and the spring conference, or different people go?
It can be different people depending on if they're able to afford it or not.
Like, for example, I did not go on NBCC last year because I couldn't afford it, but I was thankfully able to afford the spring break conference, so, like, it depends on
your ability. How many people went to the winter last year?
A lot more people went to the winter.
Do you have an estimated number?
I want to say 15 people from crew, and that was different years from freshmen all the way to seniors who decided to go. So it was a good time and experience for us to grow and learn about each other, especially coming from different backgrounds.
Any questions? Any questions? Thank you so much, and I will email you in 2 weeks and let you know what it is.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
We changed the name from DJ Night to the Navratri Festival.
That's a good idea.
Yeah. DJ Night is a little a party kind of thing.
So we have a little cut down in the
off-campus catering from 3,800 to 3,600. We bargained. Actually, Harinder bargained. For the DJ lights, we were using those sticks. That is a tradition. We call it Dandias. They are coming for the same price, 150. DJ is 850, specifically Indian. Security is 220, plus 52 is for the stage manager that goes everything to conference services. And we are using one time 250 for the worship products.
Do you have to have a stage manager now that the ballroom is free? Or is that
yes, we were charged for the stage manager this time also, and in April also.
Okay.
It is $14 an hour, I guess.
Okay.
$40.
Who's your DJ? That's a pretty expensive DJ.
He's an Indian DJ. He's kind of playing a monopoly because no one plays Indian here.
Have you ever used Chris Cook?
Chris can't play the Nirvana music.
It's typically Indian. What he does is he listens to that Indian song and he remixes it.
Oh, I see.
This has to be typically Navratri East Indian.
That's so special because we had DJ EV come for that class.
Wow.
Yeah.
Really? We had another party for DJ EV.
2 years ago?
Wow.
Really?
Wow, that's nice.
It's a big one too.
It's not bad.
He's actually being a monopolist. That's it.
Well, can we, what can we do to change that? Is there anything?
He was requesting $1,000 for the event.
We tried. So he's charging the same event, same price he charged for Diwali night from last time.
I feel like we can ship someone from New Delhi for a cheaper.
I booked my ticket for $1,200.
Okay. So how can you have, the guy who was saying that the event is supposed to happen within a certain month. So you're obviously, when is the event you're having?
November. Space has been
approved. Are people going to attend even though
yes,
it's after that month?
We had 263 people for Diwali.
Yeah.
Round about the same people.
We're actually expecting more for this.
For this one, because it is a religious event and everybody waits for it. For the North Indian and East Indian specifically.
Did he come and request for that event?
Who?
This guy from the King. The
no show.
He did not. He came, but he talked to me and he said he doesn't know how to do the events and stuff.
Plus, I checked personally, his organization is not registered also. I mean, it's registered, it's not active.
Okay.
Any more questions?
Thank you. Who is this guy?
DJ Mitchell.
DJ
Mitchell.
Mitchell.
I feel
like we
have a fancier name than that. Yeah. Yeah. Like DJ Mitchell.
DJ Mitchell.
That guy's got a good job.
You want to make a DJ Mitchell?
Give me
$500
for the other. I'll do it for
$400. So why can he?
Nobody plays Indian music. Typical Indian music. No one.
How about if I get someone from Columbus?
That's fine. We don't mind actually. Should be Indian. That's it. Even if the person is American, we don't mind. He should play Indian music.
What if
that's
he's South Indian?
That's fine.
Okay.
He should play. He should know how to play Indian music. That's it. We don't care who the person is.
$4,000 food, is it on campus food?
Yes, well,
the event's going to be on campus. We're still working out who's going to be doing the catering. We're in talking with CSU Catering right now. We're also in contact with other catering services to try and figure out pricing and what food will be provided.
Who provided the food last year?
If I could ask you to
I'm Dr. Benander. I'm the co-advisor for SAVE. Hi, this is the treasurer of our cause. Yeah, so last year was the 1 year we didn't have it, but prior to that we had it about four consecutive years prior. And so the year before last we had CSU Catering doing it, and we're in discussions with them, and it's very likely we'll go again with them, but we're trying to get another competitive price from someone off campus. I think Cleveland Vegan Catering. So we're still in negotiations with both places.
Okay.
Are you aware that your off-campus catering needs to be registered here?
Oh yeah, we know about all the paperwork.
Wonderful.
We need waivers and proof of health licenses that they have. We know about that. Well, we're probably going to go with CSU. We just want to watch it.
So what kind of food are you looking at?
Well.
So we got some information back from CSU Catering and that they can provide the vegan turkey or protein that we want, as well as a few sides for us to choose from, such as sweet potatoes, mashed potatoes, stuffing, cranberries, things like that. And we're going to do it buffet style because the event is from 4:30 to 8:30. And so it's not going to be just like a plate of food and somebody's going to be come in, take what you want, sit down, listen to the guest speakers that we have or live music. It's going to be an all active event.
We have a raffle also. The members of SAVE are all going out to vegan restaurants locally and getting donations. They're giving like gift cards and food baskets. And so we're involving the whole community. I mean, a whole greater Cleveland's invited, and then all these restaurants, they've been very generous in the past with donations. So it's a really big event. It's our signature event. It's been very successful in the past. We've had a lot of great people. We've had about hundreds of people come in. You know, between 4:30 and 8:30, you have hundreds of people coming and going. It's not just you can only eat at one time. You know, it's whenever they come in, they take from the buffet. So it's an ongoing event.
So the next year, question $300 for the professional travel coverage?
Yes.
Material?
Yes.
And that's based on prices that online about how much it would run for a nicer quality one that could last multiple years.
Mm-hmm. We want to customize it with our logo and our wording, or say wording on it, and it should be durable so we can, like Mark said, use it for many years to come.
So
any questions?
One last question. So this is going to take up the majority of your funding here with this one event. What other programs do you guys hold, or what other meetings or informational do you guys do?
Quite active. Can you talk about the movie last week?
Yeah, so for instance, we showed an Earthlings movie last week, which goes along with our education, trying to make students more aware of the horrendous conditions that animals face in factory farms. We showed an Earthlings documentary, which is behind the scenes of factory farms. But this one is our main focus. I believe is the one that will get the most students involved and show them that there are other ways of eating besides the traditional protein that comes from an animal.
Okay.
And we do have a guest speaker, professional speaker, who's not charging us, thankfully. So he's going to do some educating also at the event. And next semester, we're booking him for two long seminars also.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you
so much.
Oh, one last thing. You know what the last line here is, since you're all cordially invited.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Is it going to be like a giant tofu turkey?
Yeah, no, slices of vegan tofu.
Tofu.
Yeah, with gravy, all the trimmings. Green bean casserole, mashed potatoes, all the things. So I hope you all can come.
Thank you. Have a good afternoon.
Thank you.
Have a good weekend. So the next request is not on a schedule, because I didn't get the request from Norwood Sink, but they came up to me, so we're going to hear them.
It says
it's happening October. I don't know which order to go.
Probably, yeah.
One. They said November 15th, right?
Yeah.
No, this is their order, October 15th.
No.
They are not on
the
schedule.
Yeah,
definitely.
I'd rather give them all the next one.
Okay, because they just...
Good catch.
Thank you.
Sarah, what's your opinion?
For Dental Society. You're probably really confused right now.
No.
Hello. How are you?
They actually not on the schedule, but I didn't get your question.
We requested a financial requisition form, actually. That's what went wrong.
Off the record.
And my, and our advisor was like, why are you requesting money you don't have in your account? And I was like, oh, sorry.
So off the record, once you guys are like practicing dentists, do we get free CSU students get like a
free filling?
Free cleaning. Yeah.
Free
cleaning.
We can bet on floss though. Yeah.
Okay. Well, if you give us a lot of money, maybe we can think about cleaning.
We'll talk.
Okay, so here's one for you. So our organization is the Pre-Dental Society. So today we're requesting for transportation funds. And this will be held on December 2nd, which is a Friday. It's going to be a tour at Ohio State University. We're going to make this opportunity available not just for pre-dental students, but for pre-med students as well. And we kind of took quotes from different companies. And our cheapest and most reasonable that we found that was a 20-person bus is $1,084. The reason why we kind of scratched that out was because we changed the time in which we will come back to, which is on the second page. The reason why we don't have a formal invoice is because they said they don't give us a formal invoice until we actually book the bus. So once we have that, we'll definitely submit that in the right form. Are there any questions?
How much for the service?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
The max you can fund you $2,000 as well.
Is $2,000?
Yeah.
I mean, this covers everything. Like, we're requesting 1,000.
Yeah, 1,000. Oh, yeah,
oh, you thought the bottom one was like together? No, we were, actually that covers.
That's actually a different one. The second one covers 49 passengers, but we are just taking 28, so that's why we're just doing the minibus instead. So yeah, just cross off the 1048. We just want 1,084. Least. If you fund us 2,000, we'll take that as well. No rush, no hurry.
Yeah, so that's our fund, that's what we're requesting. And once we have the formal invoice, we'll be sure to submit that as well.
Do you have 28 people going?
We have a registration list right now with Brittany, a pre-registration. And so far we've had 8 people registered, but we do have a lot more people that are interested. This is in December, and it's pretty early. I mean, it's not even November yet, but a lot of people have expressed interest.
How many do you anticipate?
I would say we're anticipating a little bit more medical students than we are dental students. I want to say at least 20. And so there's two options. There was like one of those smaller buses that only hold 12 people, and then there was the 28. So we're like, we'll go safe with 28. If by, I think Brittany and I discussed it, if we realize that by mid-November, we notice that we don't have at least 20 people, we will get the smaller van instead. Or for that matter, we could possibly just kind of direct whoever has cars. So we're trying to make it like a formal trip. We want to make it available to the students. But if we realize down the road that not a lot of people are interested in them, we might actually just carpool.
Another thing I would like to point out is that this bus includes the tolls, fuels, gratuity fee for the driver, and everything, stereos, yeah. ACs and stuff. So.
Oh, that's the other thing. If we rented one of those little buses, then one of the students would have to be responsible for driving them, mm-hmm. and no one expressed interest in having a tip. Like, I barely know how to drive my 2006 Toyota, so I don't want to drive a bus full of people.
And also, can you put a request online so I can handle it?
Yes, we'll definitely do that.
Thank you.
So you can have a plan. Are we all good?
Thank you.
Thanks, guys. Sorry if I talked a little bit
too. Doesn't have Wi-Fi, the bus?
I was hoping that would be nice. Appreciate it. Take care.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Also, what's
that? So it's for them to check out what's used. Dental school?
Yeah. One day trip.
You're from dental school, isn't it?
No, I'm pretty sure Ohio State's like the only dental school.
Case of dental school.
It's either 2 or 3. There's very few dental schools.
We're going to the dental frat tomorrow. Do you know how much?
I'm asking how much.
How much is that?
Culture and action is not here, so we can.
No. How much money does it take to build a college for the
student parking village?
Yeah. Okay. Culture and action is not here.
No show?
No show.
I can get this if I want to pass it. Alright, so, let me begin then.
Whenever you're ready.
Alright. So basically what the Viking Village is, we're just trying to get students to go to more games on campus athletic events, because right now it's pretty low attendance. We meet with like Gary Waters, especially for basketball, and he's kind of recommending, as long as with our advisor, Ray Longmire, that we get like shirts going so we can get like unity with the students at the games, because right now we have nothing like that. So that's really what we're asking the money for, just a simple shirt that we can all wear and it looks nice in the stands and we can give out at one of the games to try to, you know, like get that college feel that Cleveland State really doesn't have that other colleges have. So really that's about all that I've got. Just, we need a shirt basically. And I tried to keep the cost down. It's a CSU like preferred provider. I think it's like $3 a shirt. And Brandon Longmire, advisor, recommended 500. So, I don't know. I think that'd be a good number. We have 1,000 emails of people who are interested in going to the games and being a part of this. So, that's basically all I have, just we get a shirt.
Is there any questions?
Yeah, it's on there. It's like $3.92, I believe. It's on the paper.
To reach. That's pretty cheap.
Yeah, it's not too bad.
What's the total?
500 t-shirts.
What's the total?
The request.
Oh, I requested 2,300 just because difference 25. Okay, because there's different sizes. Different sizes cost different amounts, and they don't really have the design yet, so I wanted to be safe.
Just to clarify, you were asking 25 in total or 1,930 in total?
I 2,500, but I wanted to be safe. That can probably be bumped down, but depending on, I mean.
So athletics, they didn't want to give you guys any funding for that?
I mean, Brandon Longmire, I mean, he works directly with athletics and he didn't say anything about it. He told us to kind of like find the money on your own, I guess, which, I mean, if I don't get it from you guys, then I'll have to go athletics, try to see if they'll do anything, but I feel like if that was possible, he would have brought that up first.
We'll talk to Brandon.
We'll let you know in 2 weeks after
opening. All right, cool.
Good idea though, we get that attendance up.
Yeah. We're definitely trying to work on that. We do think the shirts will help. So.
Absolutely.
So also, last thing, we have a Fenn Tower Senator. His responsibility is kind of to bring that community together. We want to put you in touch with him so that, like, he told us that he put up signs for a game. I don't know if you have a camera in it at all. He put up signs for a game and he said the attendance spiked just like that.
Oh, really? Okay. Yeah. All right, awesome. Yeah, I'll definitely get involved.
Thank you.
Campus is what we want. Sorry, Gabe. All right, thanks, you guys.
You got my.
Yeah, no problem.
Thank you.
So, why are these ones highlighted?
Well, next one highlighted. I don't have a request for them because they didn't put a request for all the stuff.
Cool.
So,
how
do
you have them instead?
They're going to bring the.
Thank you.
Okay.
This is the shirt?
No, this is just their logo, I guess.
This is a breakdown.
Well, this is the
part
of the
part.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. But now we do have an account number. Yes.
Yes.
I guess.
We're asking for $4,800. We just started this organization because we're recently emerging with the new film school, and so fall of 2017 we're going to be moving into a brand new building. This club is very important to Cleveland State because not only does it establish a community within our department, but we're also planning on doing multiple events with other organizations on campus. This past week, we partnered with the Gamma Phi Delta Sorority for a film screening, and then we're also working with the Comic Book Club, several government organizations, and
Student Feminist.
Yes, the Student Feminist Coalition Comic Book Club. We are, main priority is to collaborate, communicate, and produce film work as a community in the department. And we plan on going to multiple events in the Cleveland film community. The Greater Cleveland Film Commission is the one of the people that donated the money for the new film school. So we're partnering with them on, they have their event with Tom Hanks coming up in December. We're doing that, and we also work with the 48-Hour Film Project.
Requesting 425 for the screen?
Yes.
There's six different screens, right?
25, there should be. That's just the first page of it. The one that I submitted to you through the email and through the budget proposals online has the entire spreadsheet of it. But basically, we're requesting food at each of our events to have a larger turnout of students on campus, so it's not just film students coming to the events.
And all the screenings are advertised and open to all the students,
yes,
right?
Yes.
And what about the airplane meetings?
So this March, there is a South by Southwest conference. It's in Texas. We're working with our film professor now to be able to go on the trip. The three of us would be the ones attending. We are returning students for fall of 17-2. So the plan for the club is to go and participate in 27 different workshops, which we outlined in this budget proposal here. It's in the appendix of the last page. With each of the workshops, we are going to video record the information that we learned there, and then come back to the club and then do a workshop with our members.
One of our main foundations is networking, collaborating, and being able to teach what we've learned, especially for the younger generation that's coming in. We think it's really important that the incoming freshmen and even incoming transfer students have a community that they can rely on, especially as they get older and have more heavy projects and classwork, as well as including students that didn't choose film as a major, but they still have passion and want to produce work or be involved in professional discussions about cinematography and other aspects of filmmaking.
So there's a question, $2,300 for off-campus events, right?
Yes.
For the max you can fund is $1,000 for off-campus.
Okay.
Can you just make the rest?
Yes. Yeah. We plan on doing fundraising over periods of time too. We're going to have bake sales, and then we're doing a t-shirt fundraiser as well.
That's a signal.
Nothing got funded for our event of Jaguar.
Oh, okay.
So Jabba, while we're trying to raise, we already know that we can't ask for money to SGA for any type of scholarship. So we're working on outside money to get that $4,000 for high school students in the Cleveland area. So Jabberwock is open to anybody and everybody really trying to get CSU organizations involved. We've already, well, me personally sent out an email to all the President's Council of all sororities and fraternities on campus to start with them to try to get them involved. And then we're also going to shoot out an email on OrgSync to everyone, inviting every single person that attends CSU to come to this event, help to provide money to these high school students, because a purchase of a ticket, a purchase of an ad, that all goes straight to scholarship. So we're just trying to do an annual event for the entire campus of CSU. So it's open to you.
Isn't there room for you? When is your event?
December 3rd.
What day is that?
I believe it's Saturday.
Just a question.
That's a maximum of 320 people there around tables. It's going to be 40 tables of decoration.
How many people usually attend?
Well, we've never done it this big with 300, but it's always filled to a maximum. The last time we did it was in 2013, and there was a turnout of about 150 people.
What location did you?
Only 2013 was the first time we had it at CSU, and we continue having it here.
Oh, really? I thought you had it a couple years here.
Mm-mm. Okay. And then before that, so a lot of people do like off campus and also off campus catering. That's something we're trying to change, go all through CSU for catering and everything.
Wonderful.
Any questions? Thank you so much.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you.
How's it doing?
Culture.
It's been good on action. It's been good on paper.
Culture actually didn't show up, right?
And, no. Okay, this is Renee. She's here for 3 days.
Hey, PS, please hold out for a second. Now, this is my concern. So she's here for 3 different organizations. I feel like she keeps getting involved, or if I don't know if new student organizations keep getting created that do the similar things. What
are you saying? Yes, the three orgs that went to
the cross country
and the Black student.
Black Studies Elite, Belly Dancers.
And they said they couldn't make it, so I think they just kind of like double dip in.
And have her like just represent them all?
No, that's a different girl name. Her name is Brianna something.
Mm-hmm.
So she said she couldn't make it, so she's gonna come in here Monday at 11:30.
Well, I would just suggest that you ask some pointed questions to make sure that they are indeed 3 different organizations.
No, this is different, but it's like 5 different organizations. I believe they're all like trying to get the money for the same event.
Okay.
Which is that?
I don't have the breakdown of those. They're not coming today, but I can show you. They're going to meet me Monday at 11:30.
Who's not coming today?
They don't have the schedule.
Okay.
They said they have a conference right now.
We'll just ask as many questions as possible.
Okay, Matt, your name. The next two, the Valley Dance and the Vexor Union.
Oh, sorry. Wait. So this party is with Black Students Party. So it's a collaboration. The collaboration max is our 6,000.
Hi, everyone.
Hello.
My name is Renee Evans. I'm representing 2 organizations today, and I know Jamie's going to be happy because it's going to be just as easy as before.
Oh, that's what I like to hear.
And I will explain. But first, I want to do the belly dance. Our last 2 events were very successful, and I did turn in my after-event forms, and they're in your office, so you get to review those. And our belly dancers are going to do Zumba Me Belly. Our belly dancers are going to be putting on a Zumba event in the Student Center. Our instructor is coming from our rec center. I don't have the exact quote because I'm waiting on Melissa to give me that. I was in the process of getting our DJ, But when I was filling out the contract, when I got to the part where it said his social security number, he did not want to give it to me. So I told him I'm closing his contract out. And as I explained to you guys earlier, I asked Melissa on the phone, I'm waiting for my response, to see if the instructor has her own CD that she uses. If she says yes, then that's going to eliminate the cost of my DJ. If she says no, then I have to then find someone else. My food is being catered by Cleveland State Hospitality. Our order is already placed, and it's $307, but we have also given you a breakdown on that. The additional cost for food, which is coming from Dave's, is going to be the green tea that we're purchasing and our water, our bottles of water only. That takes care of everything here. Any questions?
So when is this?
This is going to be the 2nd, November the 2nd.
So the problem is you weren't able to get the money until the number 8.
But the good thing is that I did have a couple of dollars in that's left in my treasure. And the other thing is that I have money that's upstairs that I have to get back.
Can you tell us the account balance right now?
My account,
Hold on, so your event is on the 2nd, right?
Yes.
We don't fund it for a previous event, or we do that?
No. It's not a previous event.
It is previous event. Oh, she has to come to the first hearing for the day.
Yes, I can choose.
Right, Jim?
Technically, it's happening after this hearing, so that's the difficult part.
But it takes at least 2 weeks for the process.
But how they're doing funding this year, it's okay. I mean,
no problem.
What are you talking about when you said you have leftover money?
Well, I have some money that was left over into my account.
How much?
From last year.
Can you tell us how much?
And that had to be at least a couple $1,000. And then the other one, I closed it down because one of the account clubs I had. Since my members were not participating accordingly, I closed the account, the club down, and reopened it up again this year.
What club was that?
My Modern Interpretation of the Arts. I restrict the Black Student Union from getting things because I'm their treasurer as well if they don't meet the bar.
Okay.
And the same with my belly dance. If they're not following protocol, I don't request for something, or like I do with Ms. Jamie, I tell them when I come in, cancel it.
Okay, here's the issue with that is you can't use funds from one organization to supplement another organization.
No, I'm not.
Well, you just said.
I just gave you an example of how I don't use the fund of a club. That's all I do. I'm not using funds from this club for this. I'm not doing that. And then I have X amount of funds that's on refund upstairs that I haven't received back either. So that means that if so, my conference catering is done through the account. My instructor is done through the account. And the DJ may be a zero because if the instructor has her CD and the promotion is done through an account. Mm-hmm. From, you know, because they don't have the promotional downstairs anymore, so they said you can go to Jack's Print.
We still have what they call the print shop. Not the print shop.
The other one do not do, I found there, they don't do the hot cards or flyers.
Duplicate.
They do the posters.
Duplicating
the hot cards.
I went there and they did not.
I get them all the time.
You do?
The university duplicate.
We just got
them. Okay, I'll go back, but that's what they told me. So I had to go upstairs and pay my money to get my duplicate.
Yeah, university duplicating. We just got student government, like the vote card cards.
Their office is located under.
I've gone there, yeah.
So you know that.
I have a question. How many organizations are you involved in?
Quite a few.
Are you like the e-board?
I'm either an e-board or just a member.
How many are you e-board member of?
Modern Interpretation of the Arts, Black Student Union.
Modern Interpretation of the Arts.
And the Kenyan Belly Dancers. Those are the only three that I'm actually a board member.
Are you teaching your members how to do these kind of processes? So
yes, I am. Because not only that, but I have a book, and everything is written, and copies are inside that book as well. Yes.
So you said you already have a couple thousand dollars in your account, though.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Why
and then I have money that's upstairs because I haven't used, I haven't even gone to get my money back. It's when I get time to get my signature done, I did that.
And why are you using that money for that?
I just put the request through.
I mean, if you already have the money in your account.
Well, can I get it from there? I mean, I don't know this. All I'm doing is putting a request through.
But you told us you have the money in your account.
Right.
Yeah, if you already have money in your account, you can use that money for your event.
So then, let this come from there. But I still have to fill out the forms.
The form is only for to request money from SGA or VE.
If you already have money in your account, you have to fill a financial
request. Financial request form. You don't have to fill this.
Oh,
form.
So that's why
if
I fill out those.
Yeah. This is for requesting the money from SGA.
This is basically.
Okay, that's my bad then. Yeah.
Alright, so you.
So I need to fill out this a request.
No, it's called a
financial
request. The financial request
instead
of the budget.
Yeah, that's how you ask.
Okay, then because I just put out the form.
If you have any
form.
Questions regarding that, it's sort of like can help you.
Okay. I'm sorry.
No problem.
That's fine.
Let us know your what your those conversations with Student Life so we can get an idea of what we're doing, okay?
Okay.
So the next year requesting $1,500 for Black Student Union.
And I'm canceling that again. I'm canceling that because of course they didn't follow protocol. And I requested X amount of forms, as well as prices, as well as my samples. And I told them if I did not have it in a timely manner, that they were not, again, going to, I'm not going to request for funding. So this is the second time that I came in here for Black Student Union, and they didn't follow protocol, and I canceled their request.
Do they know that you're doing that?
I mentioned it to them, but they'll know at club meeting for sure. Yes.
Are you the treasurer
of the group? I'm the treasurer of the group, so yes.
Okay.
And yes.
How come none of the other members come to present? Come to present besides you?
Well, two of them are out of town for the conference. And the other person that's supposed to be at that conference is sitting over in the office somewhere. So I told them that since they did not participate, that they had to give me that money back. So I think they're kind of avoiding me right now. I requested extra amount of money for their conference fee, registration only. And that's why I put only in caps. They did not go. So the next day when I saw them, I told them that they have to reach in their pocket, give me that money back, and it goes back into the treasury. So right now they're kind of running away from me, and I'm going to reiterate that, but I'm going to look it up in our handbook so that they know that they have to follow phone call.
Yeah.
So for the belly dancing event, your belly dancing student funds will be able to cover that?
Yes.
Okay. So
but I put out the wrong form.
It's okay. I just want to make sure
oh.
That we're clear.
Yeah.
So you're not requesting any money from SGA for this year, right?
No, because I thought it was the same.
That's
thing.
Okay.
Yeah.
But
I have.
I'm sorry you got confused.
But I'm not confused on the other part. They're not getting any money
okay.
until I get that money back.
Am I correct
that I have to then show an after event form to show how that was spent. And if they didn't go, then they have to give me the money back to put back where it came from.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know how long they're going to want me for their treasure, but this is the second time they did it.
You can't pay for registration then have a student not go.
Thank you.
They're responsible.
Thank you.
Yeah.
So I will put a request in for them once those have been met, and that's another issue at another time.
Because you technically could probably press university charges against that person for improper use of university funds.
Mm-hmm. But I have two that did not go.
You could do that through ballot.
Right. And I'm just only focusing on my part with the Black Student Union, mm-hmm. not the other groups that went together. That's something else that has to be straightened out by.
Right, but if you feel the need to, you can press the charges to Valerie.
Okay.
Because that's the proper use of university funds, because they did not go.
Right. And I agree. So, when you see me with two black eyes, you know why.
Oh, no, don't
they're be like, I'm just exaggerating, because I know they're already mad at me, so. Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you so much, Renee.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
This is section.
Elizabeth, what's your opinion?
No, no, they were supposed to come at 3:15, but she was
Black
late.
Study Leaks?
No, no, go back to the
global.
So
this is the global one?
Yeah.
Oh.
So it's like red, it's like. So you're requesting 13:15 for the coffee house?
Yeah, and that's for the spring semester. So we already, like last budget hearing, we already requested for the fall semester. So for this budget hearing, we're requesting for the spring semester, so that already includes the refreshment and then rent, room rental fee, setup fee, and also custodial fee for the whole semester, and that's like 13 weeks.
Is this coffee house open policy she's doing?
Yes, it is open for American students and also international students. So we are one of like the groups in the university that caters to all the students. So we usually help them, we usually help international students to assimilate to American culture. So we do have several activities during the spring semester. And also we have...
what's the attendance? How many people attend here?
Usually like 50, like 45 to 50.
So the $1,000 for room rental is for, is this for all the days you mentioned?
Yes.
Yeah. Is this a weekly event?
This is every Friday.
And then this 13:50 will cover all these sessions?
Yes, all the sessions and also the refreshment, like please.
So you guys know, we funded you 36-35 in the first hearing, right?
Mm-hmm.
And if we funded you there, so you're going to be done for the year, so we're not able to request any money from SGA.
Yes, we understand that.
Thank you.
Involved in CSU's community, and we'd like to make it better this year. We're working with the director of sustainability. She was recently hired to create an Earth Week that engages all students with the environment. So we're working towards having different events for each day, such as like a meatless Monday to encourage people to think about vegan options. We're doing an Earth Fair on Thursday to discuss, bring in different groups such as the ODNR, the EPA, and people of that nature to interact with students.
Jobs
and different things like that.
Community outreach events that they do and also.
Yes.
We did a rain barrel event, so we were able to auction off rain barrels to the community and the campus last year during Earth Week. We did a storm drain stenciling, so if you notice those Lake Erie starts here stencils on the storm drains around campus, we did that. We were able to stencil over 60 drains in one day during Earth Week last week, or last year, so.
So the next you guys are requesting, $1,050 for the outreach material?
Yes. So we're looking to get business cards for our members that actually grow seeds in them so that our members, when we do networking events, can have a business card handout. We're also looking to get Earth Dollar Pops as a handout, a few other things.
Yeah, other promotional products and things like that to give away at events. An official tablecloth, because we don't have one of those for student organization outreach events.
What do we have then? And a poster.
Mm-hmm. How much would be t-shirts, like for a t-shirt?
Roughly $10.
I guess we're looking at what the t-shirts.
Yes.
And the business card's $300.
It varies depending on what brand you go with and how many we do. If you use the ones with seeds, they're a little bit more pricey.
Is there a unique business card?
Yes, and we're unsure of the vendor on campus. We met with him last year. We're not sure if he's a certified vendor through Magnus, so we couldn't get an exact pricing, but we based that off of his website.
Okay. So they're just they're seed paper, so instead of them just going to trash or ending up in the landfill, they actually can grow plants right now.
So for the business card, we weren't able to fund you from over finance budget, but you can use $1,050 to use.
Yeah.
Yeah, it'll be $50 short, but it's
$50.
Okay. Thank you. So the next is $650. That's okay.
Portable garden. Yes. So our goal for that is to have racks, standing racks on wheels with, so there actually is a greenhouse on campus, but it's full of asbestos, so students can't use it. Our goal is to have our members to be able to use these portable gardens to start seeds. So we will supply them with the supplies, the lights, the soil, the trays, and make it available in the geology lounge of the science building for them to use.
Are you guys advertising all these?
Yes.
Yeah. We also want to have a seed bank eventually that's going to be open to not only the CSC community, but the outside community also.
Yeah, so we actually planted a pollinator patch on garden last year where we can collect seeds from that, and people can use those seeds to grow plants. It cuts costs for future gardens that we plant by starting our own seeds. Like last year, we paid roughly $3 a plant, and if we had our own greenhouse, we could do it for probably a quarter of the cost.
So this is like a service plan, right?
Yes.
Partially, yeah.
So
it's
the
portion
it's
of
the
service
event
portion, not
service.
Yeah.
I think
they're all.
So, Jamie, it's like, it's considered a service event or
not? So the greenhouse isn't necessarily an event. That's more of a
project
that we would be doing.
So they could go. You could go through Viking Expedition, the service group, for that project, and then get your funding for the event through SGA.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Is the next question I have is the meeting for the food. Is this just for your voting of members?
Yeah, so we CSU has a new director of sustainability, and she's going to come once a month at our TAR meetings and kind of network with us and work with us to plan the Earth Week event. So we want to have offer food at one meeting a month when she comes.
It also helps bring in members.
Yeah.
Is the meeting open to CSU students?
Yeah, yes. Last time that we did this a couple of weeks ago, we had like
really
six or seven people that had never come before.
Yeah, we had engineering students.
How many people attend that meeting?
On average, they vary from 35 to about 25. It really depends on the week. Mm-hmm. Those meetings will obviously bring in more people because we plan
with the org sync.
Yes, all of our meetings are at org sync. We advertise all throughout campus for all of our events that we do.
This week we'll find it.
all the service events on Madame Ford Radio that we treasure.
Okay.
And you will contact me because that's what you guys have.
Okay.
And the rest non-service events, we end this as a community and maybe this is my first show in 2 weeks.
Okay.
Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
And if you wanted to email to Render the PowerPoint that you wanted to show today, I could look over it before delivering these.
Okay.
If you waste your time putting it together.
Are you able to just download it really quick?
I mean, I can. You can email me here.
Okay, perfect. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank
you.
Thank
you.
Happy Halloween.
Yes, happy Halloween.
She's going for a PhD.
John's not here.
Right,
the next
she like comes all around. All
the research is not here.
Took my mom.
The speaker is not here.
So this is the same old letter.
Yes.
The speaker is not here either. One second. Let's get the next one.
So what do we have?
On the previous stage, you know, speaker will be medical. So you guys are requesting $2,500?
Actually, the event that we put that service event, logistically, it wasn't working out, so we don't need that $750, but we do want the one-time $250 and the other $1,500.
That's what I agree. So, $1,750, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So the promotion items, what are those?
So we'll need to be printing one of different t-shirts and just like items that we can hand out to kind of like promote the organization.
How much is a t-shirt?
I'm sure. I think through the website online, it's like anywhere from maybe six or something. I don't actually know.
And for the other $500 for the operational expenses?
Yeah.
Where is the food coming from?
From Cleveland State.
Oh, is it
on?
Yeah, so
on
we have, right, recurring meetings that we order a catering for.
Are those meetings open to the teacher students?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is it better? I mean,
okay.
That's pretty much it. It's simple.
Thank you.
Okay.
Any questions?
Okay.
So I'm just like,
what do I mark for the other two?
Metro.
No, sure.
I should put these with
is Valerie out there?
I think they're waiting for you.
Is Valerie out there?
Yeah. Are you up?
I got this. So,
Evan?
He was
going
to say. Are
they
up there? Why? No, no. I'm here.
I know,
Valerie. $2,000 for the conference?
The Student Activities Conference?
Yes.
Yeah.
How many people are there?
Haven't decided yet.
How many were last year?
We hosted it last year, so.
I think the year before that, between 10 and 15? 12 people?
Yeah.
We
usually like the
active
people,
two years
go,
ago.
People that are always in the office, people that always come to the events.
How
I'm in a group. I'm doing a group.
Like in the whole
organization? In the whole organization? Technically in it?
No, like for instance,
yeah. I mean, 200. How many members of the IE?
Like 200.
Yeah, I sure believe so. Could you elaborate more on the supplies?
The supplies for the SAC?
There are competitions at the Student Activities Conference. They're like Micro Mouse and Sumo Robot competitions. You need to bring your own hardware to build the device to compete in those competitions. And those kits can be a little expensive.
What's happening on campus?
The Student Activities Commission is in New Jersey this year.
No, no, I'm talking about the activities.
Yeah.
You were questioning about the builder, like, I mean, funds for hardware and food supplies.
Yes. That's so.
Pretty good. It's all pretty good.
On camera.
I did not sure for it, so.
Can I go good, Jim?
Any questions?
No.
Do you have any questions?
Nope.
Thank you so much for your time. I'll let you guys know what we'll be
doing. Thank you.
Thank you.
There's a need of a waiver to
for off campus,
catering.
Okay.
think all of our food was going to be through the CSU catering.
Yeah.
Yep.
And when is your event?
The events we have coming up are, student day is December, the student day is December 3rd. The establishment event is February 1st. High school outreach event, we're still looking for, high school outreach event, we haven't pinpoint a deadline, but we know everything that like we kind of want to get involved, and we look on the CSU catering website that they have to kind of get price ranges for everything, so how much the food would cost, and then the location as well for where we want these events. And then we have the motivational speaker event that we're going to be doing.
And when's that?
That we haven't figured out a complete deadline, but it'll be in the spring, so close towards the end of.
I think we're going to do around May or so, right?
Yes.
So we have two set dates so far, and then two to be announced, correct?
The speaker planning.
Yes.
Yep. The speaker planning to do it in May.
Mm-hmm.
Probably, yeah.
Yes.
And for the veteran people.
The baking competition, right now, that's kind of, we can actually take care of that now with the funds that we do have, because it was due on November 7th, but we did want to include that. So any extra money from that would indeed go to towards our event for extra stage lighting.
I'm kind of confused there, so that's the question, $36.54 just for the food, right?
Yes.
So $13.646 can you... What are those going to be used for?
The 700?
No, he's saying for the foods, right?
No, for the 1346 is the main grounds, right? You
said
your fund balance is 646, right?
You said you're looking for the remaining balance that we have after the food. Like, what exactly are we going to be doing with that? All right, right now we were including the baking competition because one that'll go in our funds. We weren't planning on using the money that we have, so we were going to use that for the baking competition, which is kind of like our national chapter's competition for the organization to promote two of our groups within our organization to go ahead and carry out the competition. And the fee is due for that on November 7th. And then we would still need the $300 each for that, for each group to do a campaign in the spring semester, because that's when the spring semester campaign goes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
They funded them before as well?
So the total amount we're looking for is what?
$5,000?
Okay. Mm-hmm. Does that count?
Okay. All right, thank you guys very much.
For the next word,
sorry.
The problem is that then we allocated $6,000 to before that. Now they turn to the one only turn to $5,000 to the agent, but that's not fair.
No, thank you guys.
Yeah.
Thank you.
The rest of
your
anything?
You too.
It sort of seems like based on the request.
Okay,
let's
ask this question.
So I'll move in and out. Hi.
Is he
going to
sell?
Yeah, I was
going to
say,
he's not there. No, it's just the glare off the light makes me have to look the power like this.
Right.
So you looking for your good side, you're having a hard time.
Oh no, every side's my good side.
Okay.
We just get them there at the graduation.
Shashank?
No, no, your graduation.
Graduate student interdisciplinary research.
Requesting $2,500 for marketing and promotion items.
Can you tell me when is your event?
This event is on November 5th, so that's in the Student Center Ballroom.
It's the same event we allocate money for your, the call-in?
Yeah, you allocated a part of the money what we requested. So we, right now, we couldn't accommodate all the promotional items, and we are still pending with the printing of the conference books. And the status of the event is we already have like 75 presenters. We are accepting abstracts until Sunday night.
So we already funded you for this event?
We funded you $6,000 at that event.
Right, right.
From the whole event.
In collaboration with CCJC. So that time...
You can't come back and request more funds for something we already funded you for.
Yeah.
Okay, so... apart from this event, we also need funds for the regular running of the club. So
okay, so the
25 so that's a different
canceled.
Request then.
So I did put in two requests for the regular functioning of the club, and one is for the event specific.
Okay, so the 5,000 and minus 20,000. So you asking 25 just for your
right the running of the club.
Okay. For the student Ivar's $1,000.
So that's, we are having a PSS, peer seminar series, bi-weekly or weekly, depending on the presenters, within the department and outside the department. So the students come down and have it on every Friday, 12 noon, so.
So we're looking at weekly or bi-weekly?
So it depends on the presenters. If we have more presenters, we are having it on a weekly basis or not bi-weekly.
The problem is we don't fund prizes.
Okay, so cannot really say it's awards. It's kind of an incentive for sharing their results. So
we can't do that as well.
But we can fund you $1,250 for your promotional item, the T-shirts and the notepad. We can fund that $1,250.
Okay.
But you won't be able to fund the $2,500 and $1,000 for your student.
Okay.
So would you be able to work with all of them? I mean, that's the only thing is we can find you.
So if that's the only thing, that, yeah, we can have an option there.
That's the based on our rules and evaluation.
All right.
Okay. Yeah.
Now, you said for your event that you had on the 4th, you were, pardon?
November 5th.
November 5th?
Yeah.
So you were asking us for additional funds for that event. Now, what's going to happen now that you don't have those funds?
Either we have to cut short on the conference booklets. We haven't printed the conference booklets yet.
Uh-huh.
So maybe we'll send out a soft copy and ask the presenters to print them by themselves and then get it to the conference. So that's the only option we have.
Would your college be able to help you at all?
The dean's office is already sponsoring us a breakfast. So that's the only support we have from the department.
So they're sponsoring the breakfast, so what are the funds that we already gave you going for?
Yeah, we spent it on the other promotional items and booking off our poster boards. We need the poster boards. We have about 60 posters. So
okay.
The poster boards, the promotional items.
What promotional items did you get?
We got a bag, a conference bag, and a mug, and the lanyards.
Uh-huh.
What do we call the stick note? So that's a promotional item.
Okay.
We have.
Can you can't cut that. You already have that.
Oh, they already shipped it as
okay.
Well.
Okay.
So the only thing we are counting is a conference booklet. So that's the option we have. We can always send a soft copy to them and get that printed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A PDF.
Right. Yeah.
I was just making sure that you weren't going without some major part of your contract.
Yeah, that's the only thing we have right now. So
okay, great.
Yeah.
Is everyone free on Monday?
I'm only free in the morning.
What time on Monday?
What time are you guys free?
3:30
for you.
You know me, 3:30, but I
in the morning. I have class at 10:15, so anytime you want.
I'm good at
3:30. Are you sitting good on me?
Give me my pen back, Render.